Hello everyone and welcome to Unacademy platform. So let's crack NEET PG. Myself Dr. Muskan Chaudhary and I will be your mentor for microbiology. So today's topic will be Yersinia and Pseudomonas. So before starting that, let me acknowledge with Unacademy platform. So as we know that Unacademy is India's largest learning platform, and along with it gives a daily live class, daily live quizzes within which the student and the educator can interact with themselves and can ask their doubts and queries and do the polling for the question answers. And along with it, the student can keep the session recorded so as he can watch according to the time he gets, especially for the students, the doctors who are working at the OPD or the periphery, who are the medical officers. And it also gives a structured course for the whole 19 subjects, as the the MBBS consisted of the total 19 subjects, and to cover this that within short period of time, structured study is something that is needed. So I will recommend you to have at least 1-2 TA subscription. The reason is that for the interns and the post interns, 1 subscription, 1 year time period is something that is needed. And for the students, for the doctors who are working and want to, like they have some backup plans for the next year as well, I'm not prepared for this and the time left for this exam is less, so they can take the 2 subscriptions. And the difference between the 1-2 TA subscriptions in the terms of money is not much. And please, do use my code, that is Muskan, to get additional 10% discount. Now starting today's topic, that is Yersinia. Okay, so Yersinia is non-motile encapsulated and it is highly pleomorphic organism and it is non-lactose fermenters. Now, non-lactose fermenters can be remained by mnemonic shapes, that it Shigella, Salmonella, Yersinia and Pseudomonas. So these all are non-lactose fermenters. And also one more thing, that Yersinia is encapsulated, which itself act as a virulence factor for the organism. So I have told you last 2 previous classes to remember the mnemonic for the encapsulated organism. Yes, some bacteria have killer and mean capsule. Okay, now Yersinia pestis is the agent of the plague, a zoonosis, transmitted from rodents to rat flea. Rodents act as a reservoir for the disease and the vector for the disease is rat flea. Now Yersinia is the agent of the plague. Now what are the epidemiological factors? That reservoir are the wild rodents or the field mice, and the source of infectious infection are infected wild rodent, rat fleas, and the cases of the pneumonic plague. Now what is the vector? Vector is the rat flea, that is the commonest vector for the plague, and the most efficient vectors among the rat fleas, Xenophilus chiopis. Okay. This is rat flea vector for plague. Now, Yersinia pestis is responsible for the rodent-borne zoonotic disease, that is plague, and the Yersinia pseudotuberculosis tuberculosis and enterolytica. They cause Yersiniosis. The question is asked that Yersiniosis is caused by, it is caused by the Yersinia pseudotuberculosis and Yersinia enterocolitica. Now, Yersinia is gram-negative oval coccobacillus, means it is the intermediate structure between the coccus and the bacillus. So, it is neither cocci, neither rod-shaped bacillus. Other organisms, the other bacteria showing the coccobacilli structure are, one is H. influenza, Giardia vaginalis, and Chlamydia trachomatis. Now they show the bipolar staining. Bipolar staining is at the ends of the bacilli stains darker than the central part. And they also show the pleomorphism, Proteus also shows the pleomorphism, that is variable shapes and size. Along with this, Yersinia also shows pleomorphism. Along with that, it shows bipolar staining, that is the ends stain darker than the central area. And we'll see further that the special appearance of the Yersinia. It is non-motile and it is capsulated. Now, culture will read further. Now, coming to this plague cycle, plague exists in the two cycles. One is the domestic and another is the wild. The domestic means between the humans, rat flea and the rodents. Now, wild or sylvatic occurs in the nature between the wild rodents and it is independent of the human. In the cycle, the human is not involved. In the domestic cycle, this occurs between the human, rat flea and the rodents. Mode of transmission, human plague is frequently contraindicated from the rat flea. It is the most common factor. Also, with the direct contact with the tissues of the infected animals, rodents, which act as the reservoir of rodents, and direct transmission with the infected tissues of the rodents will cause plague. Otherwise, this droplet infection from one person to another will further cause the specific one is pneumonic plague. Now, also bite of an infected human flea, it will also cause plague. Now, what is blocked flea? Jab kya hota hai jab jo rat flea hota hai, when it sucks the blood from the human, so what happens? This Yersinia, this multiply continuously in the gut of rat flea, causing blockage of proventriculus. So what happens when the flea bites the next human? It regurgitates the bacteria. So the bacilli multiplying block the proventriculus of flea. The flea regurgitates the blood mixed bacteria into the bite, thus transmitting the infection. What happens that when the rat flea bite the human source, now the organism continuously multiply within the gut, blocking the proventriculus. So when it just suck the human blood, it regurgitates the bacteria back into the human blood. This is called blocked flea. Now, Chiopsis index, this is the average number of Xenophilus chiopsis per rat, and to cause the outbreak of the plague it should be more than 1. Chiopsis index is the average number of Xenophilus chiopsis per rat and is the most significant flea index. Plague outbreak is likely to occur in places having chiopsis index that is more than 1. Now, what is seasonal plague? Seasonal plague mostly occurs in the North India from September to May. Now, coming to the clinical types of human plague, 3 clinical types. One is bubonic, another is pneumonic, the third one is septic. Okay, now bubonic is the most common type and is transmitted by the bite of the infected rat flea. Now, the incubation period is 2 to 7 days. Now, what are buboes? Buboes are the enlarged lymph node. They are called the buboes. And the most common is the inguinal lymph node. Now, one more thing, that bubonic plague cannot spread from one person to another person as the bacilli are locked within the lymph nodes. So, onset is sudden and is characterized by fever. So, in the question when it is given, sudden onset fever with enlarged lymph node Ewing bubonic plague symptoms. Now, bubonic plague cannot spread from person to person as the bacilli are the logged in the bubos. Now, what are अब क्या हुआ कि bubonic plague is the most common types transmitted from the infected red flea. Incubation period 2 to 7 days का होता है and bubos are the enlarged lymph node and sudden severe fever also present with the conjunctivitis in the bubonic plague. And also the bubonic plague cannot spread from the one person to another person as the bacilli are locked up in the enlarged lymph nodes. One more thing, that in 50% of the patient they also present with the skin infection, but the skin infection, the bubonic plague resolves in 50% of the cases. It spontaneously resolves. Now coming to pneumonic plague, it results from the inhalation of the droplets from the infected patient. Now, what are the clinical features? The patient will present with the cough and hemoptysis, difficulty in breathing, along with the chest pain. And the one more thing, that pneumonic plague is the highly infectious and the highly fatal, and it can be used as the agent of the bioterrorism because it spread from one person to another. One more thing, that the incubation period is about 1 to 3 days, while in the bubonic period the incubation period was about 3 to 7 days, and here the incubation period is about 1 to 3 days. And the severe cases will call hemorrhagic pneumonia along with the fever. And hemoptysis itself is a presentation, cough and the hemoptysis, with chest pain and the difficulty in the breathing. Now, if the patient is untreated, 85 to 90% of the patient will go into the septicemic plague. Now, septicemic plague, it occurs secondary to the spread of the bubonic or the pneumonic plague. What happens, the septicemic plague, ki involvement of the blood vessels take place, causing, since the involvement of blood vessels is taking place, it will cause the hemorrhage into the skin and the mucosa, causing severe presentation, black death, causing high fever and gangrene of extremities. And decreased BP. Later causing multiple organ dysfunction. Hota kya hai ki due to severe endotoxinemia. But one more thing, that septicemic plague क्या होता है, secondary to bubonic and pneumonic plague होता है, and severe endotoxin released by the organism causing the septicemic plague. So it involves the blood vessels, according to the hemorrhage and damage to skin and the mucosa, and finally resulting into the gangrene of the extremities of the patient, causing the black death. Now along with that, multi organ failure and severe hypotension is the presentation of the septicemic plague. Now how we can diagnose, laboratory diagnosis ke liye, one is the cases in the bubonic plague, pus or fluid aspiration from the enlarged lymph nodes can be taken, and in the pneumonic plague sputum and presented with the hemoptysis, to sputum and blood will show the organism. Now iske alawa septicemic plague mein septicemic plague also blood and the स्प्लीनिक एस्पिरेट. Now, by direct microscopy, it reveals pus cells and gram-negative, that is, they are coccobacilli with rounded ends and surrounded by the capsule since they are capsulated. Now, one stain, that is the methylene blue stain. Now, methylene blue stain will show the bipolar staining. As I told you, ki jo ends hote hain, wo zyada stain karenge compared to the central part. So, they will show the bipolar staining on the methylene blue stain. And the name for the stain is the Wason stain. Now culture, they grow best at the 27 degrees Celsius on the blood agar, they are non-hemolytic but show dark brown pigmentation. We'll see the picture due to medium. Also, one more thing that I have told you, these are non-lactose fermenters, remembered by the mnemonic shifts. Now, one important characteristic feature is that ki nutrient growth pe, they will show, like as it appear, okay, as a ghee is floating on the top, like this, we'll see in the next slide. So, this specific growth on the nutrient agar, this is known as stalactite growth. Seen on the nutrient broth with oil or ghee floated on the top. Now this Yersinia present with the F1 antigen that can be detected. F1 antigen, the virulence factor present within the Yersinia that can be detected by the ELISA or direct immunofluorescence test. Antibody to the F1 antigen can also be detected by the ELISA, and the PCR can be done for the gene coding for the F1 antigen. Now we have seen ki bubonic plague, the specimen we used is a fluid aspirated from the enlarged lymph nodes, and the pneumonic plague from sputum and the blood, and the septicemic plague with the blood and the splenic aspirate. Now one question is asked for me ki jo bipolar staining, it is present in the Wason stain showing or methylene blue stain, and they will show on the nutrient broth, they will show the stalactite growth seen on the nutrient broth with oil or ghee floated on the top. Now for the prevention of the plague, since the most common vector is the rat flea, so the control of the rat flea itself is the most important step for the prevention of the plague. Now control of cases by early diagnosis, isolation and the treatment. Control of the flea by use of the effective insecticides such as DDT. Control of the rodents. Now chemoprophylaxis should be given. For the chemoprophylaxis, we use the doxycycline or the tetracycline for 7 days treatment. Vaccine are now for the vaccine, WHO recommends using vaccine only for the prevention of the outbreak within the area, but is not for the single person use or for the general use. Now vaccine that is used is a formalin K-vet vaccine, that is Sukhoi modification of the original Hafkin vaccine, and Hafkin Institute is present in the Mumbai. Just remember the name, aisa kuch pucha nahi jata. So one vaccine is the formalin K-vet vaccine, and another is a live attenuated vaccine based on the strain EV76. One is the formalin K-vet vaccine, and another is live attenuated vaccine is used. And for the chemoprophylaxis, doxycycline or tetracycline for 7 days is used. Now yeah, as I told you ki Yersinia pestis will show special bipolar staining on methylene blue stain, and it is important since it is, I told you, coccobacilli, so ends will stain darker compared to the central part, as you can see in this. So Yersinia pestis stained by the methylene ब्लू और वाइसन वाइसन स्टेन शोज बायपोलर स्टेनिंग दैट इज गिव सेफ्टी पिन अपियरेंस. वॉट आर द अदर ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट ऑल्सो शो द सेफ्टी पिन अपियरेंस? नाउ वन इज यासीनियम, अनदर इज द बर्कोल्डेरिया मेले एंड स्यूडो मेले एंड क्लैबसिला. Question is asked, organism, bacteria showing the safety pin appearance. Now one is the Yersinia, another is Burkholderia malei and Pseudomallei and Klebsiella. Now streptomycin was given the pass but resistance has occurred. So now gentamicin is given for the treatment. Now as I told you that most effective for the control of the Yersinia is control of the flea. Now vaccine we have already discussed, one is formalin killed vaccine and another is the live attenuated vaccine. Now one more thing, that yarsiniosis is not caused by the Yersinia pestis, it is caused by the Yersinia pseudotuberculosis and enterolytica. Okay, now revising for a short time. Now Yersinia is non-motile and is capsulated and is hylopleomorphic and non-lactose fermenting, causing a zoonotic disease that is plague and epidermal factors. Now reservoir the wild rodents or the mice, and the source of the infections are the wild rodents, red fleas and the cases of the pneumonic plague patients. Now red flea is the commonest vector. Yersinia pestis is responsible for the plague and tuberculosis, and enterolytica will cause yarsiniosis. Now it is coccobacilli, another of bacteria showing the coccobacilli are H influenza, and second is giardia and third is chlamydia. They show the bipolar staining, that is the ends of the bacilli stain darker compared to the central part and will show the pleomorphism, that is variable size and shapes. Also it is also present in the protease. Pleomorphism is shown by the protease. Now this is how does appear nutrient growth, showing the stalactite growth. Now two types of cycles are present, take the domestic cycle hote, another is the wild or the sylvatic cycle. Now domestic cycle, it occurs between the human red fleas and the rodents. The red flea are the vectors and mostly reservoirs are the rodents, but infecting also the red flea also infected the humans, so the cycle continues. It is domestic cycle. And the wild or sylvatic, the humans are not involved in the cycle, it occurs between the wild rodents only, from rodents to rodents by the red flea. Human does not take part in the cycle. Now mode of the transmission, the bite of the vector infected red flea, and another is the patient from man to man transmission, or the infected tissue of the reservoir of the rodents. Now block the flea, what happens? He kya hota hai ki jab red flea when sucks the blood from the person, so it hota kya hota, due to highly division of the bacteria into the gut of the flea, it blocks the proventriculars, and as soon as it suck the blood, it regurgitates the blood again into the same host, a human, and along with it release the bacteria Yersinia into the blood of the person, so causing the infection. Now cheopasis index is used as significant marker for the pathogenesis of the disease, and if the plague outbreak is likely to occur if the cheopasis index is more than 1. And what is cheopasis index? It is the average number of the Xenophilus cheopas per rat. Now clinical types, one is the bubonic, pneumonic and the septicemic. Now bubonic is the most common, and it occurs due to bite of the infected red flea. Incubation period is about 2 to 7 days, and the enlarged lymph nodes are called the bubos, and it cannot spread from person to person as the bacteria are locked up in the lymph nodes. Now onset is sudden, the patient will present with a sudden onset fever along with the headache, conjunctivitis and the enlarged lymph nodes. So it is the common presentation for the bubonic plague. Now coming to the pneumonic plague, the result from the invention for the droplet inhalation of the bacilli. And now, clinical features, the patient will present with the cough or the hemoptysis, difficulty in breathing or the chest pain, and it is highly infectious and highly fatal. If it occurs in the patient, 85 to 90% will go into septicemic plague. Only 10 to 15% will remove. So it is highly fatal and highly infectious through the droplet infection. Now coming to the septicemic plague, it occurs secondary. It is never primary. It always occurs secondary to the bubonic or the pneumonic plague. Now massive involvement of the blood vessels will take place, resulting later into the gangrene of the extremities and multiple organ failure, causing the black death. Now laboratory diagnosis for the bubonic plague, the fluid is aspirated from the enlarged lymph nodes, and for the pneumonic plague sputum and the blood is used. For septicemic plague, blood and the sputum aspirate is used. Now gram staining, it reveals the gram negative coco bacilli. Methylene blue staining will show the bipolar appearance, and this on the nutrient growth they will show the stalactite growth. Now PCR F1 antigen is present, so F1 antigen detection by the ELISA and direct eye immunofluorescence stent, and antibodies to F1 antigens are seen by the ELISA, and PCR used for the gene coding of the F1 antigen. Now prevention, the most common and effective method is the most effective method for the control of the plague is the control of the red flea by using of the insecticides at DDT. Now control of the rodents, chemoprophylaxis for the chemoprophylaxis we use doxycycline or the tetracycline, and the two vaccines are present. One is the formalin KVET vaccine and another is the live attenuated vaccine. So eosinophilus will show the safety pin appearance. Other organisms showing the safety pin appearance are the Mercatolia malai and pseudomallei and Klebsiella granulomatis. Now coming to gentamicin used for the treatment, and vaccines we have already discussed, and yersiniosis caused by the Yersinia suber tuberculosis and enterolytica. Now coming to the questions. Okay, in pneumonic plague, transmissions occur from human to human. Coming to red flea, bright red, white and respiratory droplet, we have seen that pneumonic plague occurs from droplet infections from one person to another person, while bubonic plague occurs from the red flea bite, and septicemic plague primary, it's not a primary infection, it is the consequences of the pneumonic and bubonic plague later. So the answer will be C. Now true about plague, it's seasonal spread. It is present seasonal spread because in North India, plague is mostly seasonal, occurring from September to May. Now, no vaccine is available. Two vaccines are available. Tetracycline is used for the chemoprophylaxis and treatment. For the treatment, we use gentamicin, not tetracycline. Doxycycline and tetracycline are used for the chemoprophylaxis, not for the treatment of the disease. Now caused by the gram negative motile bacteria. Now so caused by the gram negative Yersinia is non-motile. This tetracycline is basically used for the chemoprophylaxis, can also be used for the treatment, but gentamicin is preferred. So the option will be D, because Yersinia is non-motile, non-lactose fermenting, gram-negative coccobacillus. Children with thalassemia and iron overload are increased risk of patient presenting with iron overload have increased risk of Yersinia. What is not true about Yersiniosis? It is zoonosis caused by the Yersinia pestis, Yersinia enterolytica and pseudotuberculosis. Yersiniosis is not caused by the Yersinia pestis. It is caused by the enterolytica and tuberculosis. A girl from the Shimla presented to the OPD with a fever, hypotension, malaise, and axillary inguinal lymph node. Culture glucose shows stalactite growth. It is specific for the Yersinia. That this shows on the nutrient growth with stalactite growth, and also enlarged lymph nodes was so causing bubonic plague. The answer will be A. Now coming to second topic of today's, it is Pseudomonas. Okay, now Pseudomonas belong to non-fermenters. Non-fermenters cannot break, cannot catabolize the sugar, but can only oxidize the sugar and therefore cannot ferment. Now along with the Pseudomonas, important members, kon-kon se Pseudomonas itself, Burkholderia and Acinetobacter. Now Pseudomonas very important, that Pseudomonas present with the pigment presentation. Now kon-kon se pigment that is produced by the Pseudomonas. Now one is the pyocyanin. Pyocyanin is blue green pigment produced by the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Fluorescein or pyoviridin producing the greenish yellow color, and pyorubin gives a red color. Pyomelanin as we know, as it is gives brown to black color melanin, and pyorubin gives red color. Now fluorescein, something that is fluorescent mostly green or yellow color ka hota hai, and to normal jab hum dekhte ki fluorescent yellow pen rakha hai, fluorescent green pen rakha hai, so it can be remembered, it gives the green yellow color. Now bacha hua pyocyanin will give the blue green color, mainly blue then green, blue green color. So pyorubin will give the red color, pyomelanin brown, blue black color, fluorescent green yellow, and pyocyanin blue green pigment production giving blue green color. Now one more thing that in the starting, that glycocalyx produced one that is slime, and if it slime is irregularly formed, loosely defined, produced by the bacteria, and if it regularly formed, then it will give form capsule. Now slime, if slime is produced by the bacteria, so it will form a biofilm around the bacteria. So slime is produced by the Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and the patient present with Pseudomonas aeruginosa will develop later cystic fibrosis, and the collection of the slime in the lung for those patients is called alginate. Now alginate coat mucoid strains of the Pseudomonas have a slime layer or the alginate layer, facilitate biofilm formation, thus help in the addition to purulent mucus. Such strains will cause in patient with cystic fibrosis. Also Pseudomonas is capsulated. Capsule, many strains of Pseudomonas possess polysaccharide capsule. Only Bacillus anthrax give polypeptide capsule. Also both capsule and slime both are polysaccharide in nature. Now, since the slime, one thing is that the patient infected with the Pseudomonas aeruginosa will show the algate formation, and the Pseudomonas is an encapsulated bacteria. Now, clinical manifestation, Pseudomonas is one of the major reasons for the nosocomial infection and hospital acquired infection. It causes the pneumonia. It's ventilator associated pneumonia. The patient who are admitted in the hospital for the long period of time, they will gradually develop the Pseudomonas infection, that is ventilator associated pneumonia. Chronic respiratory tract infection occurs in the patient with the cystic fibrosis. We have discussed the cystic fibrosis is caused by the Pseudomonas infection due to alginate layer causing biofilm production, that is pathogenic and virulent in nature. The mucoid stains possessing alginate layer of Pseudomonas commonly cause such infections. Now, other important infections that are caused by the Pseudomonas, that is, one is the swimmer's ear. Now, swimmer's ear, Shanghai's fever questions are asked are caused by the Pseudomonas. So, swimmer's ears mostly occurs in the children, and it present with the otitis externa if it presents in the elderly diabetic patient. Swimmer's ears is basically otitis media, mainly occurring in children and elderly patient with the diabetic or those with immunocompromised patients. Now, eye infection is caused a corneal ulcer mainly with the contact lens wearers and causing later endophthalmitis. Now, Shanghai fever is the fever having similar resemblance with clinical symptoms similar to that of the typhoid fever. Now, it also causes generalized folliculitis. Questions is asked by in the jacuzzi or hot tube folliculitis is caused by the Pseudomonas. Now, other infections like skin and soft tissue infections, burn patients, Pseudomonas is one of the most common organisms to cause the burn wounds. Now, another is the ecthyma gangrenosum, and an acute necrotizing condition resulting from the bacterium occurs most commonly in the patients with the AIDS. Now, one more thing, it is also causes paronychia. Paronychia is the infection of the skin adjacent to the nail. So, what are the important infections caused by the Pseudomonas? One is the ventilator associated pneumonia, 2-4S. One is the swimmer's ear, that is the otitis media. Another is the Shanghai fever. Another, triple S, that is Shanghai fever, swimmer's ears, and the skin and the soft tissue. Since it is nosocomial infections, so it will cause the patient in the burn patient presents with the most common organism to cause the infection of the burn wounds, later causing the paronychia. And paronychia also called as the green nail syndrome, because the as you know that the Pseudomonas produces the green pigment, so the patient present with the green nail paronychia, that is inflammation of the tissues adjacent to the nail along with the green pus formation. It mainly occurs on those patients who have prolonged submersion of the hands in the water, who frequently wash the person frequently washing the dishes or the clothes. It mainly present with those patients. Now, another, it also causes the UTI and the meningitis, the post-traumatic patients, and the cellulitis. Now, important to remember is the swimmer's ear, Shanghai fever, skin and the soft tissue infections, nosocomial infections, green nail syndrome, along with the green pus formation. Now, exotoxin resembles the diphtheria toxin. One more thing to remember, that is oxytocin produced by the Pseudomonas inhibit the protein synthesis. Now, what are the bacteria that inhibit the protein synthesis? Toxins that are released by the bacteria that is don't synthesize protein. So, D for diphtheria, Clostridium, diphtheria, S for Shigella, along with EHEC and enterohemorrhagic E. coli, and P for Pseudomonas. So these bacteria release the toxins that inhibit the protein synthesis by causing the ADP ribosylation of the elongation factor 2. Now one more feature is present in the Pseudomonas, that is the quorum sensing. So what it is, a type of genetic expression in the bacteria. So when the Pseudomonas reaches a certain amount of the bacteria, so they directly communicate cell to cell for the further multiplication, increasing the number of the bacteria. So it itself is a virulence factor for the Pseudomonas. So it is a type of the genetic expression that is seen by the Pseudomonas, this quorum sensing. So one is that they inhibit the protein synthesis, elongation factor 2, and those are the bacteria that causing the inhibiting the protein synthesis is Clostridium, diphtheria, Shigella, and the Pseudomonas. And one different feature of that, they express the gene expression for the further cell to cell direct communication, that is quorum sensing. Okay, now coming to the laboratory diagnosis, one is the direct collection of the pus and the wound swab or the urine causes a UTI. So, and it present directly a direct smear, it presents with a gram negative bacilli. Now on the nutrient agar, it showed the metallic sheen due to presence of the release of the blue green pigment. And one more thing, that the Pseudomonas strains male pigments are diffusible pigments. That is, they diffuse into the surrounding media. And another bacteria showing the diffusible pigment is Staphylococcus aureus. And the non-diffusible pigment is shown by the Serratia protegiosin pigment, that is non-diffusible. Now on the blood agar, they show the beta-hemolytic gray moist colonies. Now on the meconium agar, they are non-lactose fermenters. A selective media is the cetrimide agar. Now cultures may motility, they are motile, gram negative bacilli. Biochemical identification, that is, they are catalase positive. Question is asked, that is, they are catalase positive. Selective media cetrimide agar, and nutrient agar, they will show the metallic sheen as if something is reflecting from the media. Nutrient agar vaisa dikhega, due to the presence of the pigment, blue green diffusible pigment. Now this is showing the cetrimide plate. And this will show the greenish fluorescent under UV light due to diffusible pigment released by the Pseudomonas. Now this is blood agar showing beta hemolysis and grayish moist appearance, showing the grayish appearance by the Pseudomonas, the blood agar. Now this is Paranoica infection, showing the infection of the adjacent tissues to the nail and the severe condition, releasing the pus, causing green pus syndrome, Paranoica, mainly on the patients who mostly keep their hands wet. Now culture selective media, already told it, it's cetrimide agar. Now another growth pigment is enhanced on the another growth media, that is King's media. It favors the production of the पायोविरिडिन पिगमेंट प्रोडक्शन। गिविंग गोल्डन येलो अपियरेंस। Now, question is asked, what are the antibodies used for the pseudomonas that can be remembered by the pseudomonas in campfire? So, campfire, carbapenem, aminoglycosides, monobactam, this is P, sorry, polymyxin E, that is another name for colistine. FO fluoroquininol and third generation cephalosporin. So campfire, carbapenem, aminoglycosides, monobactam, polymyxin E, fluoroquininol and third generation cephalosporin and extended penicillin. Now these are the cephalosporin used in the for the pseudomonas. Now revising the topic before doing the question. Okay, now it belongs to the non-fermenter families. Now non-fermenters families do not catabolize sugar. They hence do not ferment, and the pseudomonas, Burkholderia doria and acinetobacter are the important members of the family. So the what are the pigment produced by the pseudomonas? One is the pyocyanin. Pyocyanin gives the blue-green pigment production, blue-green pigment. Fluorescence, one the fluorescent, so the what is the fluorescent color we commonly see? It's green yellow, so greenish yellow. Pyorubin R is a red color, pyomelanin, melanin brown or black color deta. So bacha hua pyocyanin gives the blue-green. Okay, now alginate coat, the pseudomonas present with the formation of the biofilm. So it causes the cystic fibrosis in the patient, resulting into the increased biofilms or slime production called as alginate. Now it is capsular polysaccharide, that is it is capsulated organism and made up of the, it is polysaccharide in nature. One that is bacillus anthereus present with the polypeptide capsule. Now clinical manifestation is the one of the most common, it is the most common bacteria causing the to infect the burn wounds. Other than that, it causes the ventilator associated pneumonia, chronic respiratory tract infection, that is cystic fibrosis, swimmer's ear, Shanghai fever similar to the typhoid fever, and the skin and the soft tissue infections, and mainly in the burn patients present with the infected burn wounds, and ectima gangrenosum causing the necrotizing condition, mainly present in the patients with AIDS and or the immunocompromised patient, and green nail syndrome, that is the paronychia resulting from the inflammation of the tissues adjacent to the nail, along with the green pus formation, mainly occur in the patients for the who keep their hands submerged in the water for prolonged period of time, and it also causes the cellulitis with the green pus formation, UTI and the meningitis mainly in the post-traumatic patients. Now exotoxin, that is mainly protein synthesis inhibitors. Now other protein synthesis inhibitor toxins, bacteria are the don't synthesize protein. So D for diphtheria, Clostridium diphtheri, S for Shigella and Pseudomonas, along with the enterohemorrhagic E. coli. One important property is that they show the quorum sensing. Quorum sensing is the gene expression that causes direct cell-to-cell communication, and once a particular density of the bacteria is reached, Then they cause cell-to-cell communication. This special gene expression done by the pseudomonas called as quorum sensing. Now a laboratory diagnosis. Laboratory diagnosis sample is a pus and the wound swabs, and on the Newton agar they present with the metallic sheen due to the pigment production. The pigment is diffusible pigment into the surrounding, that is diffused into surrounding mein phail jata hai, diffusible. Another diffusible pigment production is by the Staphylococcus aureus, and non diffusible pigment by the Serratia. Okay, now a selective media is the cetrimide agar, and these are the oxidase positive. Now test on the cetrimide agar under UV light, they will show the pigment production. Okay, now this is blood agar showing the grayish moist colonies. Now this is paranoica with paranoica showing the inflammation of the adjacent to the nail bed with the slight greenish appearance, later forming the green pus. The green color is due to the pigment produced by the pseudomonas. And culture media one, we have used as cetrimide, and the pigment is enhanced in the King's media, showing the golden yellow colonies. Now campfire can be used to remember the pseudomonas antibodies, that is carbapenem, aminoglycosides, monobactam, polymyxin E or colistin, fluoroquinolone or third generation cephalosporin with extended penicillin. Now coming to the questions, most common gram negative organism in cystic fibrosis. As I told you that Pseudomonas aeruginosa produce the slime, and the collection of the slime causing the biofilm production, and it is called as algate in the infected patient. So Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Significance of the mucoid strain Pseudomonas aeruginosa is that they exhibit more drug resistance, produced slime. So I have told that the algate strain produced more slime or biofilm. So they produced biofilm. Now ecthyma gangrenosum is produced. I told you ecthyma gangrenosum is a necrotizing condition caused by the Pseudomonas. So A will be the answer. Drug used in the Pseudomonas treatment, as I told you, for the can be remembered by the mnemonic campfire. Now polymyxin E or colistin is used. Other than this, the third generation cephalosporin used that are cefepim, ceftazidim, cefoparazone and cefepim. So B and D. Okay, so thank you for the today's session. I hope that I have cleared some your topic or the doubts, and please do use my code, that is Muskan, and have a tight sleep, and before that study well.